Hello, this is Roman from Custom Scene. In this video, I will show you how to design your first digital planner in Procreate with a digital planner creator. We will see some basic customization and tips and how to use some of the great features of this kit. Because Procreate has its limitations, depending on the device you are using, the process is slightly different compared to other design apps. But still, very simple and fun to use. I will take you through the whole process. Let's get into it. First, open Procreate. Let's make a split view of Procreate in one side and files in the other. Import your files. A little trick here is with your two fingers, select multiple files in one go. Drag and drop in Procreate. Once importing has finished, select all your imported files and make them into stacks. Now, we're going to repeat the same process with other files. Same thing, we select all our files, import them, and group them into stacks. Once our stacks are done, let's rename them. We call this one Planner Parts. And this one Small Planner Ring Binder. Now we're done. Let's customize the cover of our planner. In the layer panel, we select an element and select the change color layer, select your color, and drag and drop your color into the element. Repeat then the same process for the rest of the elements. Elements are separated, so you could also hide the lock button for a different style. Let's add our design to the cover. Just below your design here, drag and drop your elements. Use the transform tool to reposition and scale your element. Add as many elements as you need. This is looking good, but let's add some text. Go to Actions, Add, Add Text. Type your text. Change the color. And reposition your text as needed. Here I'll duplicate this layer to have another text. and add my first planner. The cover of our planner comes with several options. Let's see some of them. It comes with elastic bands and several other options of locks. Simply hide or display some of those elements. Each element is movable and scalable. Let's change the color of this lock. For this tutorial, I will use this lock. Another feature is the ability to change the texture of some elements of your planner. For example, here you can change the texture by turning the layers on and off. I'll use the leather texture for this example. You can also bring the opacity down. Another feature is shadows. Some elements have different options of shadows. For the cover, you can display shadow option 1 or shadow option 2. Let's now resize our canvas. Go to Actions, Canvas, Crop and Resize. In settings, we'll change the values. Let's do 2732 by 2048 pixels. Let's move the cropping area to the middle and press Done. Let's add some items to our scene. I previously imported some items to my Procreate. I'll select my item. Let's change its color. Select the Change Color layer and drag and drop the color. Let's copy the item. Go to Actions, Copy Canvas. Now let's go back to our cover and paste our item. In Actions, Paste. With the Transform tool, let's position our item as we need it. Let's add more items. I'll select this one. Let's customize this color. This item has two changed color layers. So we will need to change the color of both layers. And once we're done, we copy our canvas and paste it in our cover scene. And let's repeat the process with more items. Yes, this is looking very good. Let's add our last item. And we're done. Now, let's add some background to our image. The Digital Planner Creator comes with several background options. From our files, we will select a background and simply drag and drop the background above the background layer. With the Transform tool, we'll resize our background image. Let's try another background. There is also a background folder called Backgrounds JPEG Grayscale. Grayscale backgrounds will allow you to change the color of each background. To do so, select your background and drop it into your scene. We will scale it and reposition our background. And change its blend mode to hard light. Press on background color and select your color. For a touch of realism, you could also add overlays. The Digital Planner Creator also comes with several options or overlays. Drag and drop into your scene, above all layers. Change its blend mode to linear burn and play with the opacity for different results. With the Transform tool, resize your overlay. Let's try with another overlay, and we repeat the same process. Thank you. perfect. I think I'm very happy with the result. Let's customize the inside of our planner. The first part will be to customize is our planner base. Same as before, we select an element, look for the change color layer from the color picker, select our color, and drag and drop the color on the element. Now repeat the same process to the rest of the elements of your planner. Now for the lock, I will use a different lock. I will hide this one and go in the Planner Parts folder. I will select this lock. Let's customize it and change its colors. We will also adjust the textures to match our planner. And we're done. This lock has two parts. Let's import each part individually. We will hide the bottom layer and copy our item and bring it into our planner base. Repeat the process with the bottom layer. We will need to rearrange the layers. And by sliding right, both parts of the lock, we can move them together at the same time. Let's add a design to the base of the planner. Files, we select our design and we drag and drop it just below the Your Design Here layer. We'll transform and reposition our design to fit our design to the base planner and change the opacity of our design. Now, let's add one item to our planner. And let's put it just inside the pocket. Let's choose a pen for a planner. And let's place it just inside the pen holder. Let's rearrange our layer to put the pen just in between both shadows and layers. display the shadow option too, to add this little detail, as the pen fits just perfectly inside the pen holder. We can also resize the shadow of the pen holder to fit it better. Let's add and customize an extra zip for our planner. I'll select zip number 3 and customize its color. We can also add an item inside the zip. I'll choose this item and customize it. I copy my item and I paste it inside the zip. To make the item look like it's inside the zip, rearrange your item layer to be just below the zip open layer. This doesn't look right. Let's fix it. With your selection tool, let's draw a rectangle on the part where we want our item to be visible. Select our item and select mask. And done. Oh, wait. Let's move the zip slider to a better position. Now we're done. Let's copy our zip and paste it on our planner. This is looking pretty good already. But let's add some more details to our planner. The base part 2 includes several pockets. We'll hide unwanted pockets and change the color of those pockets to match our planner. And I will also readjust the textures. Let's add some items to the pocket. I'll choose this sticker. Let's add our design to it and change its color. Copy canvas and paste it with our pockets. Let's add another item. Bye. And because the pockets are separated elements, just place your item in between both layers. Let's add more items. This is a picture of my hometown, Seville. Beautiful streets. Bonitas calles. And this will be our last item. Thank you. that's it. I'm happy with the result. Let's bring those pockets to the planner base. And we're done with customizing the base of our planner. I'll select the inserts.
Because this is the first page of our planner, I'll hide the left paper insert.
I'll customize the right paper insert. Let's change the color of the binder base first. Then I'll change the color of the paper insert. The effect of paper stacks can be hidden. I'll drag and drop my design. Add some elements to it. And we're done. Let's bring this first page to the planner base. Let's add some divider tabs. Paste the insert that we previously copied. The insert will be used as a reference for our tabs. To add more tabs, simply duplicate the divider folder. And reposition them to the right place. Let's customize each divider tab. In this one, I'll add a home button.
let's rotate our canvas.
That's better. Double tap on each tab to edit the text. Let's change the text of each tab. For this example, I will copy just the first tab. I will copy the rest of the tabs later. Back to your planner base, paste your tab. Repeat the same process with the other tabs. And we're done. This is the first page of our planner. Something is missing. Let's customize and add some ring binders to our planner. Each ring of the ring binder are separated. This means you can change the color of each ring individually. It also means you can hide some of the rings you don't need, or move them. Now, let's copy those rings, copy canvas, and paste it in the base of our planner. Now we're finished with our customization. Let's customize and create an open view of our planner. I will just duplicate the right insert to keep our design. Change its color. Let's do the same with the left inserts. We drag and drop our design just below your design here layer. And with the transform tool, we reposition our design. Let's not forget the little details. Let's change the color of the paper stacks. Copy canvas and paste it in a base planner. We will need new rings. Select ring binder 2. We will customize them. Copy canvas and paste it in our base planner. And this is how the open view of our planner looks like. And this is it.
I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. All elements used in this video are linked below.
Please like this video, and if you have any questions, please leave a comment below.
And I'll see you in another video.